step-by-step process. The first thing we have to learn is how to calculate the number out of a 2D surface. So if we have a box, we want to know how many books will fit in the bottom row of the box. So when calculating how many will fit out, you must test your object against the box or 2D surface size 2 times. First, we're going to test it one way. Let's say it's this first option here. Then we're going to turn the book on its side and say, well, if we turn it on its side, can we fit more books? And whichever number is greater, that's the number we're going to go with. For example, if we wanted to put an 8.5 by 11 book into an 11 by 17 by 10 inch box, we must see how many 8.5 by 11 books will fit within the 11 by 17 inch box. Then we're going to rotate the book, so the box stays the same, we'll rotate the book, and this time we're going to test how many 11 by 8.5 inch books will go into that 11 by 17 inch surface. We're going to refer to it as the option 1, option 2 method. We're in essence just turning the book 90 degrees to see if we can fit more books. Let's look at that visually. So when you write this down on your cheat sheet for your exam, I would write what's on this slide right here. Test option 1 is going to be the box size length times the box size width divided by your, let's say your book or your item, your book's length divided by your book's width. We're going to test that and see how many books will fit out. When we're done, we're going to take the same exact formula. If you look at this, it's the same exact one, except at the bottom, instead of dividing by the length times the width, on the bottom we're going to divide by the width times the length, which allows us for that 90 degree rotation of the book. Now, take note that the whole number result of each division problem is the number you're going to keep. So if I divide the box length divided by the item length and I get 8.4, I can only say that 8 will fit out because I can't have 0.4 of a book or an item or whatever is going to go into the box. So I just take the whole number and keep that. So let's walk through the example that was on the previous slide. Test option 1, the box size is 11 by 17 by 10. But we're going to ignore the 10-inch side because it's always length times width times height unless otherwise specified. So in this equation, I could care less what the height of the book is right now. All I'm concerned about is how many books will fit on the bottom row of the box. So the box length is 11 times the box width is 17, divided by the book length, which is 8.5, and divided by the book width, which is 11. When you divide this, you should come up with 1.29 by 1.55. But because we don't keep any decimals, we're going to drop off the decimals in the problem, and we get 1 times 1, which means we only get 1 out in this box if our book is turned on its side like it is right now. I can visually see that I can fit more in the box, but I can't fit another book in that area. So option 2, and ignore this should say option 2 right here. Option 2 is the same formula, so 11 by 17, that's the size of our box, divided by, now this time we're going to switch the bottom values. So the width of our book is going to move to the left-hand side, and the height is on the right-hand side. So 11 divided by 11 is 1, and 17 and divided by 8.5 is 2. So 1 times 2 is 2, so if we turn the books 90 degrees, put them up on their side, we can fit two books into our 11 by 17 inch box. So if we were to compare option 1, which is 1 out, and option 2 is 2 out, you take the greater value and say that we can fit 2 books out in this box.